I have a question for all of you sitting here. Have you ever been to a circus? I'm not performing for you, but just asking. How many of you have been to the circus? Okay, great. We've all been to a circus, and what do you find at a circus? You have the ferocious lion, you have some wild beasts, and what do these animals do for you? They perform tricks, right? They're performing tricks. And why do they perform these tricks? That's only because they're trained. And why are they trained? Because there's people who train them with whips, with electric shocks, with wires, in the most inhuman way. Now, these are very extreme cases, but this is what our society is also about. Our society has always condemned and punished failure. It starts from my childhood. You know, when a child scores less marks in his exams, he's always looked down upon. It's synonymous to a crime. Now, with this fear of failure and the guilt of not being able to cope up with society standards, it makes children susceptible to stress, depression, and sometimes even suicidal tendencies. It's not just the kids, it's also the adults. You know, with this little risk of failure, this chance of failing, an individual never wants to try out anything new. It's just this small chance of failure. Well, as I've been introduced, my name is Larissa. I am a YouTuber, a digital content creator, and I am very, very happy to be living the life because I found my passion. I also have the chance to interact with a lot of motivated souls out here because of my social media channels, and also tell them how I made it this far with this magic potion, and how I found this magic potion to what they call successful. Now, if they call me successful, who am I to talk about failure here? Well, let me tell you that I've had my share of disappointments in life, and I've failed so many times that after a point, it became a routine. And after it became a routine, I started enjoying it. Now, all of you look really very puzzled when I said I started enjoying my failures. Now, let me tell you how I started enjoying my failures, how I overcame them, and how I became the person I am today. Let me make this talk a little interesting with a story about how I came this far. So since the time I was a little girl, I have been very much inclined towards art and anything to do with art, so much so that I even took up craft when I was in school. Now, school was not a great place for me because of all the bullying and drama, but I was this shy, chubby, reserved little girl with big dreams. And I remember, even though I had these big dreams, I came back home almost every day with tears in my eyes because I hated school and I don't miss it. I'm sure all of you miss school, but I don't miss school at all. Now, cut to 10th grade, in my SSC board exams, I scored an 84% and still didn't get into the college of my dreams, the high school of my dreams. Now, the teenage Larissa was shattered. She was shattered because college was supposed to be everything for her. It was supposed to be an escape from all the bad memories from school. So I thought, you know, forget 10th grade, let's move on to 12th grade, I'll get a better college then. So I studied science for 2 years in my 11th and 12th, and I wanted to be a vet, a doctor, or maybe a psychiatrist. Little did I know about this course called commercial art, where I could become a graphic designer and still keep that fire of art alive within me. So, you know, very honestly, I had no mentor when it came to deciding my career. So I decided my career for myself. I was my own mentor. I told myself, you know, Larissa, go ahead, take this risk. There is nothing to lose. So I said, okay. I went on, I told my parents, you know what, I don't want to be a doctor anymore. I want to be an artist. Now, my father, like any of our fathers, was petrified. He said, nothing doing, you can't do this. But the rebel that I was, I said, by hook or crook, I am going to become a graphic designer, and I'll do it. So I went on and I gave the entrance exam for JJ School of Art, and I was rejected again. Now, that killed me. That killed me because, not because I had just failed, but because I had rebelled at home, I had fought, and then failed. So I, very honestly, learned nothing from these rejections from college. The only good thing that happened during that time was that I got a guinea pig at home that my dad brought for me to cheer me up. That was the only good thing. But apart from that, I kept self-sympathizing with myself because I felt like a loser as I did not get into the college of my dreams, not once, but twice. So I went on, and I knew that I could get an admission in the JJ School of Art by giving a donation, but my family couldn't afford a whopping donation of 7 lakhs. So I said, never mind, I'll do a diploma course instead. I wouldn't do a graduation. So mind you, this diploma course college wasn't any fancy. It was a standalone building with no campus, a handful of kids, and that itself made me feel horrible. But I had no option, I had to do it. And before I could join my course, my dad said these few words to me that has still stayed with me, like, and it's going to stay with me forever. He said, child, don't be upset because you didn't make it. Think of yourself as a fish. I said, what? He said, yes, think of yourself as a fish and this college as a pond. And you're going to swim through this pond and become a big fish. You're going to be a big fish in a small pond. Well, at that moment, it didn't make any sense to me. I thought, fish, pond, what? But until a few years after that. So this, all of this happened in the year 2010. And in 2011, I was in the second year of my college, and I realized what he actually meant. I had started exploring my possibilities with a lot of things. I started modeling for my friends, and I started also creating a few items, customized products for my friends, and started selling them online. So these are the things I started doing. And like I said, I tried modeling. I went on to participate in this contest on Facebook. And I won a photo contest. And for that, I got a photo shoot as a prize. And this was a very cringy picture. I know you're all allowed to laugh. But back then, it was really cool when I did this photo shoot. And I thought, okay, wow, you know, forget graphic design. Now I want to be a model. So I went on to participate in the Pantaloons Fresh Face contest, and I was kicked out in the first round in itself. So back then I realized, okay, maybe, you know, maybe I'm cute, but definitely not model material. So I went on with to come back home. I was very upset with what happened, and I was so embarrassed. I felt, you know, I should have actually done something that I was really good at. So it struck me how I was creative and I was good at art. So I said, okay, you know, I'm good at art. I already make a lot of customized products for my friends, and I sell them online on Facebook. Why not make this into a business? I want to be a businesswoman now. I want to be an entrepreneur. So I sat down with my laptop, and I made this page called We Love Custom-Made on Facebook back in 2012. Where I would sell my customized products to my friends or whoever wanted to online. The internet is a big world, right? So this was the year 2012, and I remember this was my crafty little venture. Everybody was really happy about it. And I also remember calling myself the CEO and founder of this company. It was also on my card, printed on my card. So after this, I went on to do We Love Custom-Made, and I also took up tattooing. So for We Love Custom-Made, I customized umbrellas, sunglasses, and I did a lot of different things. And as I took up tattooing, I became a tattoo artist, and I could say I have scarred 40 to 50 people for the rest of their lives. And just kidding, I didn't scar them. I did a pretty good job. But it was a good experience, and I was doing well. So I finished my diploma course for 3 years, and I still kept doing We Love Custom-Made for 2 years after that. And it was doing really well. So when I did this, I knew that I had to take this forward by making at least a website for it. So in 2012, I made a website for We Love Custom-Made, and this website had a payment gateway. Now back then, a website with a payment gateway was very, very rare because the only ones having it was Amazon, Flipkart, eBay, and some major international brands. So when this happened, I thought I had achieved something really, really big. So my next step forward was, you know, now that I've achieved a website with a payment portal, I am going to be in the newspapers. I wanted to be one of the cool young entrepreneurs in the newspapers. And surprisingly, that happened. I was on the fourth page of the Times of India as a budding entrepreneur, and there was a whole article about me. You know, this felt like I had arrived. Now, definitely, the applause and the validation from the public, from media, it made me feel great. It felt like I had arrived. But after a point, I realized that even though Wheel of Custom-Made was generating a revenue, it wasn't enough to scale it. I mean, I couldn't grow it or expand it. Rather, I did not know how to do it. So which meant that I had no idea of the A to Z of business. I had no business mentor, I had no business background, and very honestly, no business in my blood. So just wanting to be a businesswoman at that point didn't really make sense. So I thought, you know what, I think I should give up on this Wheel of Custom-Made company, rather project, and move on with life and do something that's real and move on to a regular job. You know who was the happiest at that moment? My father. He was really happy that I moved on to a regular job. And I remember feeling like a complete loser, feeling like a complete failure, because I had worked on through this project for so long, not for, you know, to give this up, but I had no other option. But back then, I remember, if I did not have Wheel of Custom-Made then, I wouldn't have been amazing at all the things I'm good at right now. The things that I learned from Wheel of Custom-Made were things like online presence, how to deal with 20-odd customers, and in turn, increase your communication skills with brands, how to build a website on your own with a payment gateway, how to market your social media channels, and most importantly, even though you have the skills to be amazing at whatever you are, you need to have a team to expand and grow. So all of this away, I had to move on to a regular job. It was the March month of 2015 that I was appointed as a graphic designer at a media company. And I worked there for 3 months, and I quit because I got a better job after that. And it's definitely nothing I'm proud of. I totally regret it. But that showed how stupid I was with my decisions which came at making at a job. I didn't know what to do at when I was at a job or what to do with it, rather. So now when I look back at it, I know that I should have learned how to build a team, how to build my relationships at a company, and everything to do with that. So moving on to the new job that I got at a social media analytics app, I was appointed as a graphic designer again, and I worked there for a year and a half. After I worked there for a year and a half, I repeatedly started working on my YouTube channel and my Instagram, and I did really well on that. I worked so hard on it, I remember that only because my office was really far away from home, I rented out a space that was close to my workspace, and I started living there. And on weekends, I used to work so hard on my YouTube channel. I used to film, edit, and upload it, and work on my Instagram. I worked really hard, and that was the ultimate hustle. It was something that I really enjoyed. But after a year and a half, the company policy started changing, and they mentioned how they had to downsize the company. Now, when this happened, it was the 25th of August. Today is the 25th of August, by the way. This happened on the 25th of August, 2016. And I remember 10 to 15 people were supposed to be fired from the company, and I was one of them. So I was fired overnight without any notice. I was asked to leave immediately. Now, when you're fired, you know what happens, right? I broke down, and I didn't know what to do with my life. My world fell apart, and I knew I had to pay EMIs, I had to pay bills, I had to pay my rent, and everything was due. It just shook me so much. But somehow, even though I felt humiliated, I knew that something kept me calm. it made me realize that, you know, the past experiences of rejections for college and everything else, it's made me accustomed to this, and it's made a routine, and now I know how to rise up from my failures. So I knew there's no other option. I had to go on with my YouTube channel. I was very, very calm when I was fired. And I came back, I started working really hard on my YouTube channel, and I went on with it. If it was a few years ago, I wouldn't have been that strong. So after that, after 2016, I've only seen my career take off, and I've never, ever, ever looked back. And only when I look back, the only things that I look at are the things that I've learned from these situations and from my failures, and the fact that everything happens for a reason. Now, in the past 3 years, I have found my passion, and I live by it. I have squeezed the hell out of it, and I've failed. Mind you, I still keep failing. I fail a lot of times, but I know how to rise and how to get better at it and come back with a better idea. It's been 14 countries that I've traveled to, 14 different countries, and I've worked with the world's biggest companies and brands. And I am glad that teenage Larissa was strong enough. She was rebellious, and mostly, she was very, very resilient, and she did what her heart felt like doing. I know it's been 8 years, and it's taken me 8 years to be where I am today, but you know what? Nothing happens overnight. There's nothing like instant gratification, I know, but nothing happens overnight, because even Rome wasn't built in a day. And you know, just like I've made my mistakes, I'm sure even when they built Rome, they replaced a few pillars and stones here and there, and you will do too. But remember that when failure comes at you, you accept it, you acknowledge it, but rise from it and come back with a better idea and a better plan. Tackle it very smartly. Remember that your journey is not going to be something that you'd ever, ever, ever want, but it's going to be something that you need, that you really need. So be nice to yourself, and the most importantly, grind your teeth at failure. Grind your teeth, be courageous, be resilient with so much persistence, that when failure comes knocking at your door, you know you have to take a good laugh at it, but wait and wait and wait and learn from it. Thank you.